Yes, yes, of course you did, of course you did.
Yes, I did. It's not right.
No, it's not, is it? Is it really bad? Am I being a naughty boy?
But what about Trudy?
Why come round for stimulating conversation when I can give you this?
Oh, I can see why she fell in love with you.
Oh, just shut up about bloody Trudy and enjoy the ride, okay? Besides, there's no one here. We've got the whole place to ourselves.
Oh.
Damn it!
A mistress! You're going to try and tell me this was some kind of long-term arrangement. every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock when I go to evening market. You've been having magical mistress hour. Oh, no. What am I saying? Knowing you, it will be less than a minute.
No. It's the first time, I swear.
Hello? I don't know. Mistress? Bits on the side?
Whore! Sarah was not a whore! She was the only friend that I had.
Man has needs, Trudy. It's been over a year. What did you expect?
How many times do I have to tell you this, Richard? I am not attracted to you anymore, but that certainly does not give you the right to go sleeping with my best friend. The cheek of it, really.
Susie, you're missing. Even if we both tell the police it was me, they'll still be pointing the finger at you. You're the one who had the motive.
Yes, but it was an accident. If you tell the police the truth, everything will be okay.
On what planet are you living on?
Planet Earth, Richard. Planet Earth. And let me tell you, right now it has one very unhappy inhabitant.
Yes. But you're missing the point, dear. If maybe this, I don't want to see you go to prison. I mean, if you go to prison, who will I have then, eh? Sam's dead, you'll be banged up, I'll have no one. The main thing is, of course, I don't want to see you go away. You call the police now without a plan, that's exactly where you'll end up. Trust me.
Trust is not a word I associate with you right now, Richard. But you are right. They will think it's me. I'm not going to prison for something that you've done.
Excellent. Now we just need to think of a plan and everything will be all right. Look, I thought you said we didn't have any guests today.
I didn't think we did.
Well, come quick. Stop.
Oi, anyone there?
Hello?
All right?
Yes, I'm all right, thank you.
Since the Bel Air Hotel here.
It is indeed, young man.
Can I come in?
Just get rid of him.
Can I come in?
I can't quite hear you.
Move the body.
Can I come in? The door's locked.
Yes. If you'll just give me 1 minute, I'll be right with you.
What did you say you'd be right with him for? We've got a corpse on the floor. He can't come in. We haven't got a plan. We need a bloody plan.
Well, he knows we're here now. We have to let him in.
Oh,
one moment, Bobby. 1 moment.
For the last time, Richard, move the body.
What? Where?
I don't know. Anywhere. Just hide it.
Hoodie, not answer the door.
Oh,
no, she never does the same thing. No, that would be far too easy.
It's all your fault, Richard. All your fault. The cloakroom cupboard. You're putting her in the cloakroom cupboard.
Well, funnily enough, Trudy, I've never contemplated the perfect hiding place for a dead body in a hotel before. Have you got a better suggestion?
Yes, Richard. Our bedroom. The one place in the hotel that hasn't got public access. Good grief.
Right. Fine. I'll move.
Oh, you haven't booked You haven't got a reservation.
No.
A bit of a last minute thing to come in.
Oh, I see. Premier Inn up the road was full, was it? Last option, were we?
Richard, I am so sorry about my husband. He's been somewhat overstimulated today.
Yeah, well, we're on our way to Land's End. Been driving all day. Carrie's exhausted.
Understatement. Oh, my God.
Well, we were just driving past, saw the light was on. Thought we'd stop here for the night, finish off the rest of the journey in the morning.
Well, I'm afraid that won't be possible. Look, you'll see we're actually fully booked.
Anyway, the sign outside says you've got vacancies.
No, Richard. The last guest left early today. Besides, we can't deny a pregnant woman a good night's sleep now, can we?
Oh, isn't it though? See, women knows, is it?
I'm sorry. Is that an actual sentence? Just a collection of random words strung together.
Yeah. That'll be £55, please.
And what, may I ask, dear, room are you getting with the light for the couple?
Room two, Richard.
Ah, room two, room two. No, I'm afraid that won't be possible. You see, we've got a leak in room two. It's not really fit conditions for anyone to stay in, let alone a pregnant lady. Maybe you would be better off at the Premier Inn. I believe I've got...
No, I had the room that leaked into last week, Richard. The room is in perfectly good condition. However, if you do experience any problems at all, please let me know.
See, even the doors don't stay shut in this place.
Oh, well, it's just as well they aren't sleeping in the clerk room cupboard then, isn't it?
So amusing.
If you'll just follow me, I'll show you to your room.
Thank you, sir.
That's right. Take all the time you need. We've got nothing to do.
Oh, thanks.
Stupid, stupid bitch. A perfectly empty hotel, and she actively goes and invites them in. No! And you, stay in the cupboard, you dead bint.
Are you?
Truly! Don't be so disgusting!
I wouldn't put it past you.
What the hell are you thinking letting him say?
For a start, I am not turning away a pregnant lady. And secondly, we have the vacancy light lit up out there. Now, how unprofessional would it be if we turned away a customer when we have the vacancy light on? Bad customer service, Richard. How many times do I have to explain it to you? Word of mouth. The best form of advertising.
Yes, I suppose you're right, dear. And how do you think they're going to rate our cosy little establishment? Hmm? What are they going to say? Yes, the room was very lovely, the manager very pleasing to the eye, but I'm not sure about the cold feature in the bloody reception!
Well, we're not going to find it, are they? Besides, poor girl looks ready to drop. And you do have a plan, Richard, don't you?
No! I said we need to think of a plan, and you've just got to make it 10 times work. Hang on a second. Ready to drop? You mean she could give birth here at any moment? Oh, wonderful! That's just marvellous! Fantastic! Well, I suppose we could ask the paramedic when he arrives whether he's got room in his ambulance for our corpse! Thank you! Now!
I'm not caring for your tone, Richard! You're giving me a headache!
You've always got a bloody headache.
Oh, I'm having an aspirin and getting lying down.
Yes, that's right. Leave all the actual work to me. It's funny how whenever anything needs to be done in this hotel, you go and get a bloody headache.
You started this, Richard. You finish it. Worst case scenario, we'll wait until the morning, and we'll move Sam's body after the couple have gone. Oh, and can you change the vacancy light to full? We don't want any more custom now, do we? Do you think you could just do that little thing?
You do it. The switch is right under your bloody nose.
Gentlemen.
Detective Inspector Loomis versus Detective Thomas. CID.
Detectives. CID, you say.
You seem a bit agitated, sir. Is everything all right here?
No, but it's just that it's not every day we get CID detectives in a quaint little family-run hotel.
Like?
Bell End Hotel. Award-winning hotel, in fact.
Your name?
Actually been awarded since 19... Oh, sorry, my name. Yes, sorry. My name is Richard Powers. I'm the manager, stroke owner of this establishment. My wife, Trudy, is in bed. How can how can I help you two gentlemen this evening?
There has been a murder.
A murder?
A murder.
Oh, how awful.
Actually, several murders. All in the last 24 hours.
Who murders? Wonderful. I mean, where did these murders take place, may I ask?
Well, the first murder occurred in a neighbouring village, sir. This morning. And we're not at liberty to divulge any further information at this time.
Well, quite. I mean, in a peaceful part of the country such as this, I mean, nowhere is safe, is it?
We have a potential suspect to the complex. They're currently at large and on the run.
A suspect? Well, that's good. Knife fooling you with a hoodie, was it? Broken Britain and all that?
Not quite, sir. Well, we do have reason to believe that our suspect and his accomplice may have passed through this area in the last few hours.
Oh, well, thank you for the warning, Detective. My wife and I will be sure to keep our eyes peeled.
Well, if we give you a description of our suspects, perhaps you could tell us if you've seen them today.
Well, as you can see, Detective, we're not really the sort of hotel that the murdering type is likely to frequent, so I'm sorry, I'm not sure how we can help.
Suspect one, white British male, age between 25 to 32, medium weight, approximately 5'11 in height, blue eyes, hair short and brown, last seen wearing yellow polo shirt and blue denim jeans. No other significant features. Suspect two, white British female, aged between 25 to 32, average height, blue eyes, medium length brown hair, last seen wearing pink top and blue tracky beads. No other significant features. Oh, significant features. Female suspect is heavily pregnant. Have you or your wife seen anyone fitting this description?
What day did you say?
Today.
No, haven't actually had any guests at all today. No, the last guests we had left yesterday, and they didn't fit your description at all. No, a couple of homosexuals, I believe, yes.
I mean, I wouldn't have let them in at all if they hadn't have put in those ridiculous equality laws.
I mean, the Bell End Hotel can do without the big pound. Thank you very much.
But I always abide by the law, being a law-abiding citizen and all that. Well, this place looks like it could do with every pound if you get its hands on, regardless of the colour.
Well, no, we're just going for a bit of a dry spell, that's all. So, yes, nobody here, just me and the wife. No guests, no passengers, nothing.
Well, if you do see anyone, sir, fitting descriptions, you will let us know, won't you? There's my card.
Yes. Thank you, Detective.
No guests, you say?
Hmm?
You said before you've got no guests.
That's right.
Well, a sign outside says you're fully booked. You don't want to be losing customers now, do you?
Oh, it's not, is it, Detective? Oh, bloody wife. I keep telling her to change it. Thank you, Detective. I'll get it sorted right away. Right, fine. No time like the present, is there? Oh, would you look at that? It's not working. Faulty wire, no doubt. I mean, I never wanted to get the thing in the first place. It's so frightfully American and crass. Thank you, Detective. I'll get my handyman out to have a look at it in the morning.
Yeah, I might be
as well.
I'll
be
fixing things.
And Detective Thomas, oh, look at that. You fixed it. Magical. Thank you, Detective. Faulty wire, as I suspected. Yes. Don't worry, Detective. I will get my handyman out just to take a quick look in the morning, make sure it's safe. So, if there's nothing else, okay. Good night.
Okay, Richard. Might not. Well, Thomas.
He's gone.
Oh, wait. He only was right up.
Trudy! Trudy!
Shush, Richard. The aspirin hasn't kicked in yet.
Trudy, I've got it. I've got a plan.
Number of murders, all taking place today. So why the bloody hell can't I find anything about it on the net? I mean, surely this is national news.
Why do you want to find out more information? I thought you said this plan was easy. We framed Sam's death on him upstairs.
Yes, dear. But in order to do that, it would be helpful to find out how our madman guest upstairs has been disposing of his victims. Bollocks. If he's shot or stabbed them, that won't fit with Sam's method of death at all.
So what you're hoping for, Richard, is a psychopath who kills his victims with a vase. Oh yes, I'm sure that's very nice. This plan is ludicrous. It'll never work.
Look, we've got a dead body in that cupboard that we killed.
You?
And I killed. And we've got a psychopathic killer guest upstairs. It should be perfectly easy to frame him. For God's sake, Trudy, this plan has fallen into our laps.
Yes, but like I said, if he's been on a little shooting spree, that's not going to fit in with Sam's knock on the head. Questions will be asked.
For all we know, he could have been killing people in all sorts of ways. There may not even be a plan.
No. It's me that watches Midsummer Murders, and let me tell you, there is always a pattern, always.
Whose keys are these?
Oh, they're the serial killers. He left them here when he was checking in. I was going to take them up to him.
Car keys. This is perfect.
What is?
We move Sam's body to the boot of the psycho's car. Then you can return the keys whilst altering the detectives. And when the police arrive, it won't matter whether he's shot, stabbed them, or whatever. If the body is in the boot of a person's car, then it's on them, and more importantly, not on us.
My giddy up, Richard. That almost sounds like a good idea.
Good idea. It's a bloody marvellous idea. And I will follow it.
My keys! Oh, I've just spent the last half hour looking for them.
What keys?
Those keys.
Oh, these keys?
Yeah, my keys.
No, I don't think these are your keys.
No, my car keys. By the way, don't really want to go into it, but if anyone comes in here, looking for me or Carrie. You ain't seen us, and we're not here. All right?
As you wish.
Cheers, mate. See ya.
I've got it.
Another plan.
Yes, one that's sure not to fail this time. You invite those two downstairs to the dining room for some complimentary food or something, doesn't matter what. Keep them in there. Whilst you're in there, I'll rush upstairs, go and get the psycho's car keys, move Sam's body to the boot of the psycho's car, return the keys, you can call out, we'll call the detectives, and Bob's your uncle.
I mean, how long is it going to take you to do all those things you just said? What if I can't keep them in the dining room that long?
God knows you can ram it on for at least 10 minutes. Just don't let on that you know who they are.
Very well. I'll go and invite them down.
Good girl. Remember, who am I doing this for?
Yourself, Richard. Don't think for one moment I buy your pathetic dribble about wanting to protect me. You just don't want to die a lonely man.
Don't want to die a lonely man. I don't need you. Why the hell did you have to go and die, eh? First time you release your pent-up passion on me and you snuff it. Do you know, I blame Trudy entirely for this. If she hadn't have gone so insane, I'd never have thrown that vase.
Did you shoot your husband, dear, then?
Yes, that's right.
So much to do round here, though. So on the way down here, what we thought was trees and country and shit like that.
Right.
Yeah, I think I'm allergic to the country, babe. And I've blocked up loads ever since you came here.
Well, there's a lovely little village just down the road and a super shop. It sells the most delicious cream teas.
Oh, what, like Starbucks, Jane?
No, dear, it's an independent shop.
Independent? What's that?
Yeah, imagine like there were only one Primark in the old country. That'd make it one of a kind, independent thing.
So it's like everything here in Hudson.
Well, nearly. Except for the beach resort and the Premier
That's like a top shop though, isn't it?
No, dear.
Has it just Rudy's
got
up
on
that?
Oh, no.
Trudy, hey! You do not know what you've missing. See, what I like about where we're living now, yeah, is that if you go to our upper town, all the shops are the same. You know exactly what you're getting. Well, good, isn't
it? You two come from London, then, have you?
Huh? Croydon.
Okay. What brings you down this way, then?
Oh, I've always wanted to go to Doncaster, innit,
though? No, this is Devon, my love.
Oh, yeah, Devon, that's the one!
Oh, I've got a relative anyway, I've seen it all the time.
Okay. Well, if you'd just like to come through into the dining room, I'll show you the menus.
Actually, Jack, mate, I'm not really that hungry. When you stop the services a little while, you guys.
Will you just go into the dining room and order some bloody food?
Richard!
And what I mean to say is that I'm sure Trudy won't be offended if you can't finish your meals, and it's all part of the package, isn't it, dear?
Yes! Yes, that's right. I won't be offended. Do come on through. Jack, come along.
Yeah, leave it, babe. It's not worth it.
Through the back. There you go. Come on, dearie.
Quiet.
Over here, take away the beans. Richard, they really do not seem like the serial killing types to me.
Well, they're hardly going to have it tattooed on their foreheads, are they, dear? Just get in there, keep them in there, I'll come and get them done. Oh, what the fuck are you doing here again?
Well, I do hope you don't greet all your guests like
Martinez?
No, it's just that you made me jump, that's all. And what did you say? Guests?
Yeah, we'd like to book 2 rooms. The old Premier Inn at the Rose Bowl.
You want to stay here?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, you are an hotel, I do not. Bell End.
Bell End Hotel? Yes, yes, we are.
And you are not fully booked, are you?
No, we're not, because I told you that earlier, didn't I?
Those 2 motors out the front. They both yours?
Yes! Yes! Mine and the wife's.
The big Volvo. That's your one, isn't it?
Yes, yes, that's right, Detective, yes. Big, solid, reliable, like its owner.
And your wife's? Can't see what make it is from it.
Do you know what? I'm not actually sure. No. She only got it the other day, you know, just a little run around.
Just a little run around.
Yes, well, that's all women really need, isn't it?
Oh, hello there.
Hello. Detective Inspector Lewis. You must be Trudy. Oh, this is Thomas.
The IC.
Yes, dear. The two gentlemen I was telling you about earlier. They want some rooms. They want to stay.
Oh, how lovely. Well, I'll just leave you to register them in then, shall I, Richard? I'll get back to fixing that broken vase in the dining room.
Yeah, I'm on the answer. I'm good with fixing things.
Detective Thomas, aren't you a jack of all trades, eh? No, I'm sure my wife can manage, can't you, dear?
Yes, dear. I'll just get back to it right now, dear. Bye-bye.
Excellent. I'll be in to give you a hand just as soon as I've finished saying to the detectives. Okay. Cash or card?
Cash.
That will be 110 pounds, please.
Bit of a dump you've got here, really, isn't it?
No, not really. Many guests who stay here, this is where I'm with that. Many guests who stay here describe this what's the word? A retro.
Yes, I'm sure that's what they all say. I'll expect you to give with a few quid to do it up, all right?
Not really, no.
How much would you need? Couple of grand minimum, I reckon.
I'm not really sure where you're going with this.
It's not so much how much you need. It's more how much you demand.
No, you've lost me. I'm sorry.
No, I haven't.
So I suppose you'll be going off up your rooms now, eh?
I'll tell you, Sky.
Yes, every channel you can wish for. Why don't you pop upstairs and have a little flick?
Eh?
I'm so sorry you ran out of chips, my dear. I'll make you something extra special in the morning. How does that sound?
Chips. Sounds marvellous.
Well, I think Lady Luck was on our side. The detective's car alarm went off before you came in. Twice.
There was no luck about it, Richard. I went round the side of the building and threw a stone at the detective's car to buy us time to get them up there. And I came out to tell you that Jack has his car keys in his pocket. I heard them jangle when he sat down.
Bollocks. Okay. New plan. You go in there with that couple whilst I'm seeing to the detectives. And see if you can get Sarko's car keys while you're at it. I'll come and tell you when I'm done.
Oh, agreed, Richard. That might be the second time I've interrupted them. It's going to look very rude.
Oh, for God's sake, Trudy, these people are serial killers. You should be more worried about being brutally murdered by them, not being rude to them.
There you're going with that tone again, Richard. I am not going to stand for it.
Oh, for God's sake, just go now. And make sure the detectives bend their leg properly this time. Ha, ha.
I think that bloke's crazy like nuts. Yeah, what do you reckon he wasn't making noise after you?
I dunno. But there's something fishy going on around here. Pop and spin. What?
You think they've been here then?
No! I think they're here right now. Don't be bollocks up there, so I did it. Right, you check the kitchen, and then outside and have a good look around, right? I'll check in here and then I'll go upstairs.
Right, well, Trudy is seeing two of the beds. Where's the other detective?
He's just stepped outside for a cigarette for bed.
Ah, excellent, excellent. Well, your rooms are room 3 and 4. Here's your key, that's to room 4. And if there is anything else, detective, please don't hesitate to give either myself or my wife a call. I hope you have a very pleasant evening.
I'll put this wet umbrella in the cupboard there, if I may.
No, it's okay. I'll do that.
Oh,
well, okay, we'll do it myself. No, I insist. It's part of the package.
No, I insist.
No, serious, I wouldn't feel like it. I just feel
like... What's wrong with you, man?
I did nothing.
I'm perfectly capable of doing it myself.
Bloody hell!
Bastard!
Ah! 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 Ah!
Now, what the bloody hell am I going to do with you, eh? You're alive, Sammy, my dear. You're alive. You're alive. You're alive. She's up there with the serial killer, in fact. They've been up there for over an hour.
I suspect they've got a lot in common, you know, bloodlust and all that.
I can't believe she tried to kill me. Maybe I thought she tried to kill you.
Well, isn't it obvious? And she saw you as a threat, didn't she? I mean, naturally, I am the love of her life. She'd stop at nothing. Oh, Sammy, I'm so glad you're alive, my dear.
Oh, sorry,
Shit, I forgot about you. Where the hell have you been?
I was having a stroll at the back and I got lost.
You ain't seen Detective Loomis, have you?
Oh, yes.
Your detective is upstairs in bed, said he didn't want to be disturbed. So your room is room 3. Here is your key. A very pleasant evening.
Hang on a minute. You're not his husband.
Detective Thomas, don't tell me you've never played the naughty, eh? You know?
Oh, shit, silly me. That's the word. That's why you were acting funny before. You were hiding your mistress from your wife.
Sharp as a bristle you are, aren't you?
You sly dog, you.
In all seriousness, though, Detective, I am in love with this lady here, and I do plan to spend the rest of my life with her.
You do?
Yes, Sammy. From no longer will you be my mistress or my bid on the signs. No, from now on you'll be my lover. Forever and always.
Oh, ain't that sweet? Listen, I'm going to leave you two lovers to it. But don't you worry. That's the word.
That's right. That's it. That first on the right. Idiot.
Do you really mean what you just said then?
Yes, every word. I mean, you've been a spinster for a whole 6 years, me and Trudy have known you. And now, if I try to kill you, I'm the only one you've got left. I'm sorry to state the obvious, but I think you need to hear it.
You're right, you are. I guess I need you now more than ever.
Yes, and I need you as much as you need me.
How many should try to kill me? What bitch? 6 years we've been best friends, and she only does that.
Yes. I mean, my wife's obviously not the woman we thought she was. She's a ruthless killing machine.
I'm
going to
kill her.
What? I know, Precious, I can kill her for what she's done.
No, I mean it. No. I'm going to kill her. You go upstairs, get rid of that old detective, and I'll finish off the Trudy. And then we can blame it on those guests upstairs. And then we can be together, just you, him, and me.
Sammy! How could you think such a thing? It's fantastic.
Richard!
Bunny, quick, hide. Yes, dear, 1 second. Quick, hide. Yes. No. Get down, down. Shh.
Richard!
Yes, dear, 1 moment. I'll be right with you. Yes.
Shh.
No.
Richard!
Yes, dear, 1 second. Shh.
Yes, dear.
You are so rude, Richard. What did you do? Forget about me?
Forget about you, dear. How could anyone forget about you?
Well, you stay with the serial killers in their room, you said. I'll come and tell you when the coast is clear. You said that was an hour ago.
An hour? What's it happened? That time flies.
Well, is everything okay? Is everything okay? You know, with the detectives.
Yes, everything's fine. In fact, everything's just peachy.
And you call this peachy, do you?
Well, yes, there was one little hiccup. The detective found Sam's body.
And you killed him?
Yes.
Oh, my Lord, Richard, what are you turning into?
I'm not turning into anything. I didn't want to see you go to prison.
And Sam, what have you done with Sam?
I put her in the freezer.
The freezer's not big enough to hold the body.
I chopped it up.
I chopped it up!
Yes, with an axe. I chopped it up and put it in the freezer.
No! Oh, good Lord, Richard! Oh, grotesque, divine of emotion!
Will you stop being so melodramatic? I had no choice. I didn't want to see you go to prison.
Anyone else get murdered while I was up there talking to the other serial killer? What about the other detective? What did you do with him? Put him in the food blender?
Food blenders?
Oh, I'm going to be sick.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. He wasn't here when the other one discovered poor Sam.
I feel faint, Richard. I don't think I'm going to be able to take this anymore.
No, no, no. There's none of your fainting today. Up you get.
Why? Don't touch me.
Why don't you go and have a nice lie down, dear? I'll sort everything out, yes? Oh, you didn't hear any of that, did you?
Nope, I was throwing up all over the back of your kitchen. Why?
Oh, it was just a thing she was saying about you, Sammy. Horrible, vile, venomous things. I was just sitting there hoping and praying that you weren't listening. Listen. Do you really want to go through with this?
Yeah, sure you do, yeah.
Excellent. And if this plan is to work, we need to get rid of that Joe Pasquale fella too.
Yeah.
All right. Go and make sure Judy's asleep. Back in a jiffy.
We can't stay in the same place. We shouldn't be here. We need to keep moving.
I do. When we said we were staying here because I was exhausted, it was the truth, you know. We've been on the run all day. I need my sleep, innit?
Very close by, I can feel it.
We've been saying that since yesterday, babes. And we ain't even driving in your car. We brought your dad's. They ain't going to be able to track us down. Well, he's fine, all right?
Oh, I'm sorry to put you through all this, babe.
Whatever.
Oh, I thought I'd be able to make the payments.
You made no payments, Jack. That's why I left you now. And like I keep telling you, if they do catch you, first thing they'll do, break your legs. That's all.
Yeah. It were only 30 grand. I never thought not paying it back in time would end up with us being in this mess.
For fuck's sake, Jack. It's not like you took out a fucking loan in a fucking NatWest, is it? What do you fucking expect?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, mate.
You done me lots of favour in that bedroom now. Can we go up and get some sleep? I'm knackered, innit?
Yeah, all right. Come on then.
Oh my God!
Oh, why is it?
Oh my God!
Oh no, your water's having broken up, mate. Oh no, and your waters really do break, I might not believe you.
Trust me, darling, when my waters break, you'll know. My mate was in Sharon, yeah, you know, from Bingo. She says when you're sleeping with her, all sorts of stuff comes spurting out. Blood, shit, piss, the lot. You'll know, darling, trust me. You'll know. Come on.
I can't wait.
Change your mind.
Them serial killers up there, they ain't serial killers. He's just some guy that borrowed a lot of money. And them detectives, they ain't CID. It's a loan shark or something.
Bollocks. My perfect plan ruined. Without serial killers, there's no reason to frame.
We're gonna need a plan B.
We haven't got a plan B.
We need to think of one though, and quickly.
Spend our special time together, you know, alone.
Silly me, of course he loves you. Oh, this is stupid. Where is he?
Where's who?
Loomis.
Up in the land of Nod, no doubt, as we all should be.
It's rather late,
yes.
Yeah, I think I'll try one more time.
What?
Where
are you, Piper? Detective, are you aware that our hotel has such a thing as ringing termites? Yes, they're actually everywhere. They sound suspiciously like a mobile phone ringing.
Where are you ringing?
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. What? In the village, the peaceful village, the lion sleeps tonight. Ventilation, it makes it sound like it's coming from down here, but it's actually upstairs. Why don't you pop up there and have a look, okay?
Okay. He's coming from that closet!
What?
What's he left me there for, the silly salt?
Well, I suppose this is now as good a time as any.
For what?
Why don't you go and find out, then, Detective? Strangulation, just open the bloody cupboard, you ignorant donkey.
Ah!
No commotion here. Right. We'll have to wait until that couple have gone in the morning before we can finish off Trudy. We can't take any more risks getting caught. Move him through to the kitchen.
Open the door.
I believe the door appears to be stuck. Yeah. I'm just looking for my spanner. I'll have you out there, Jim.
Richard!
Yes, dear. I'm just fixing it right now, dear. I'll fix it, dear.
Richard, what on earth have you been up to in here? The body's fallen out of the cupboard. And I'm worried about that other detective finding out what's going on in here. Have you got a plan?
Questions, Trudy, my dear. Yes, I have a plan. You don't need to worry about that other detective.
Well, don't tell me you've killed him, too.
Yes.
How did you kill this one?
Well, this one wasn't quite so pleasant.
I don't want to know.
No, it's probably best you don't, dear.
Weren't you hiding behind your back, Richard?
Nothing.
Okay, how did you kill him? Alex!
Yes, but you know, his head came off. Then it was surprisingly little blood.
I need a drink,
No, you don't, dear. Alcohol, remember, just give you a headache, make it worse. And why don't you pop on through to your bedroom, have a lie down? I'll, clear all this up.
Did she see the end?
Yes. Had to tell her it was me, of course. Right. As soon as that couple have left in the morning, we can get on with it. You'll have to stay in there overnight now. And I need to think of another way of getting rid of those bodies. Then you can do it. You can kill Trudy. Snack, eh? Oh, you'll be here for a while yet.
My wife never does things by half, probably cooking you a full-blown meal. Oh, why don't you sit down?
Actually, can you tell her we won't be staying after a while?
Better
off.
Oh, really?
You're
sure?
Okay. Hang on! No, we can't go yet. My ring. I think it must be up in the room.
Oh, come on. You probably just left it in the car or something.
A special one. Mine.
What ring was it?
The one that says I heart my mum.
Oh, that cheap Argos thing. I'll get you
one
for
it. This is my ring. That's a well-crafted one, that is. And my mum bought it for me.
Fine.
I need to
find it. No, come on. Let's just have a look. Get out here. Come on.
Oh, will you break up your bloody mind? Are you staying or are you going?
We are going just as soon as we find this stupid bloody necklace.
I'll bring out your food in a moment, but in the meantime, here's your coffee. And where are they?
It's our idea. They've just gone upstairs to look for something. Oh, Trudy, dear, you look like that's a crap. I tell you what, why don't I take this and you go and have a lie down, eh? It's been a long night. I'll make sure they go. I mean, stay, of course.
Well, if they do stay, wait until the morning before you call the police. That way we can say that we woke up and found all this carnage.
Yes, good idea, dear. Don't worry. No, you go and park your rump on the bed and leave everything to me.
That was close. She really saw me in there.
Yes, she did. That's a finisher off there and then.
Have you thought this through, though? If I kill Trudy, there's three dead bodies. And I've got no serial killer, no one to blame her.
I've had an idea. You know that area outside by the dining room window?
Yeah.
Well, I always wanted to build a conservatory there. You know, expand the eating area. It'll be lovely in the summer.
What's this got to do with dead bodies?
Good Lord, I thought Trudy was so. Buried a dead man's bodies in the foundations of a conservatory. It'll be quite fitting, actually, because I've always wanted a conservatory, but Trudy's been dead against it.
Now she'll spend an eternity dead under it.
Dead men's cars? They must have come in a car.
Well, that's even easier. Drive them to a remote location and torture them.
All right, so we wait for them to get upstairs to leave, and then?
Then? You go back and hide in the dining room. When the coast is clear, I'll bring Trudy out from here, and we will sit down here. Then when the moment is right, I'll give you some sort of trigger word.
Trigger word.
I know. Conservatory. When you hear me say the word conservatory, I'll sit back, you can come out, and get on with it.
All right then, how shall I do it?
Well, I'm always saying she's off her bloody head. So let's... And you were such a pro with it last time, so let's stick with the axe, eh?
All right then, axe it is.
Good girl. And remember, what's the trigger word?
Conservatory.
Excellent.
Told you, you probably just left it in the car or something. So just get out then.
Ah, has the time come to say goodbye already?
Yeah.
If you find my ring, can you post it back to me, please? It's got real sentimental value.
Certainly not. Off you go.
Really?
Go on, get out. Don't mind your type in here. Riff raff. Redecorate the reception area, do up the kitchen, and then, of course,
There was my idea for
a conservatory!
You knew all flinch like that, Richard. How many times do I have to tell you a conservatory will take away too much space from the garden area?
Oh, but you know how much I've always wanted a conservatory!
Well, I know you have, Richard. But that's not going to happen now. You'll have to say goodbye to that dream and every other dream you've ever had.
Oh, but a beautifully constructed conservatory!
Shut up about your blooming conservatory!
Oh, but an architecturally designed glass conservatory!
By the way, when I went to the dining room earlier, I saw Sam. I thought you said you chopped her up and put her in the freezer, Richard.
No. You've killed her, haven't you? Oh, thank goodness, Trudy. I wanted to tell you all along she'd come back from the dead.
She hadn't come back from the dead, Richard. We just thought she was dead. Obviously, neither of us knows how to check for a pulse.
Yes, quite right, dear. Honestly, Trudy, the woman's completely deranged. She forced me into a plot to kill you. So she'd kill me if I didn't do exactly what she said. She's obviously a ruthless killing machine.
Richard, that's just silly. You don't have to worry. She won't be killing me now. I've seen to that.
Excellent. And I've got a new plan this time. A plan that's sure not to fail. We bury all the bodies in the foundations of a conservatory that I'll build. I'll start work on it tomorrow. Then we can take the excess cars to a remote location and burn them. Do you know what? I don't know where this idea came from. It just hit me.
Sam! You got that rope now? Want to do the honours?
Of course.
She was alive when I went into the dining room earlier to make that couple their food. me everything that you'd been up to. How you killed those two men, and how you forced her into conspiring to kill me!
No, hang on a second. I only killed one of those men. She killed the other, and it wasn't even my idea to kill you. It was her idea.
Well, that's not what Sam told me. You told me yourself you killed those two detectives, who I actually understand were loan sharks.
Yes, but I only told you that, because I didn't want you to know that Sam was alive.
Honestly, lie after lie, who do you think I'm honestly going to believe?
Trudy, you have to believe me. She's just as bad as me in all this. She's murdered, and she's planned to murder, just like I did.
Oh, give it up, Richard. The truth is out.
And you two, lesbian lovers. This is going to be some sort of sick joke.
The only joke around here, Richard, is you. I was coming home last night to cook your last supper, as it were, and tell you all about me and Sam, and that Sam, I have booked one-way tickets for me and Sam to go to Panama to live! Oh, that reminds me, Sammy love. We better wrap things up. Our flight leaves in 5 hours.
No, wait a second. Wrap things up.
Sammy, you got the petrol?
Petrol?
Oh, Richard, there's no point in struggling. Sammy has excellent secure knots. I should know.
Help! Help! Help!
Richard!
Perverted!
Oh, shut up! I didn't want to see you with another woman. You married
her! No, of course I wouldn't! And what kind of sick pervert get turned on by being tied up with them? Shouldn't be ashamed of yourself! You're a pervert, mate! Bloody pervert! Bet you're one of those paediatricians too late! You
play with, you can do with some loosening up.
Oh, God, come on,
Perry. Hi, Sam. Can you smell
petrol? No, of course I can't. I told you, since you came here, I can't smell nothing.
No, seriously, I can well smell petrol.
Oh, well, you've been going on about since you've been pregnant. It's smelling petrol and Jaffa cakes. Come on, let's just get up here.
Do you really not want to see me with another woman?
No, of course I don't. I'd join in, have a threesome, innit?
Oh, I love you, mate.
Oh, I love you too, mate.
Indeed, my love.